Totoro, we left off by saying that we needed to create an, icons. We want to use these little icons. Now, the traditional way of doing this was to use images. But images have the problem of they can't really be resized, recolored. They get pixelated, they get too big. They're also a large file type. So the new thing that people are switching to recently is icon fonts. Font Awesome really made this popular, but I mean, icon fonts have really been around since, if you remember, Wingdings from even the 90s, and I'm sure even before then. Now, the latest thing is called ISO Moon, and ISO Moon really is my favorite thing right now. They do have a free plan, so you can play with this without paying any money. I don't even think you need to even sign up or anything. You just use their account. I actually got their basic plan. I didn't need their unlimited, but their unlimited does have some nice things. First off, with their basic plan, you do get the main feature is that you get to save your like your storage, save your fonts. So you can have various projects and then save them, which is really convenient for me. So if I'm working on multiple projects at once, which I usually am, I can have a different icon set for each one. And you'll understand more what I'm talking about as we get into this tutorial. So if you just load your icon set, I actually have a few projects. Now, really what makes this nice is that it takes icons from various different subsets. So Font Awesome is one of them. So it's everything in Font Awesome, various other ones. Along with ISO Moon created a little set of their own that they felt was like a nice little thing. It also allows you to upload various clients maybe that you have. So for my own website, I need to upload client logos. So I uploaded just various icons, and you upload an SVG file that you can then alter and control. So for example, there's no icon in the icon set for jQuery, and I need a jQuery in there. So I made my own. But for this tutorial, I'm not going to show how to make a custom icon, rather use one from scratch. So to start, let's create a new project in here. And we're going to call this Getting Started Tutorial. And you can call whatever you want, probably meaningful to what you're doing. And we're going to load it. You can see that we have a empty tutorial or empty library right now. So the next thing to do is now we have to go and search some icons. So let's go add one. And they have all these different libraries, which are nice. You can even purchase your own. I don't think they're very expensive, but they have a wide selection, which is really nice. But let's just look at the ISO Moon free option. So now the nice thing about ISO Moon and what I really enjoy about it is that you select only the icons you need, and you're not loading a bunch of icons you're not using. And that is kind of a downfall of using Font Awesome. So the first icon we're going to need is a mail icon. And we're also going to need a phone icon. So let's do both of them, and they don't have to be exactly right. So let's go look for some mail, see if maybe we can match the same one. And it looks like it's not really exactly what we're looking for, but to demonstrate the point, let's just use something like this. So we added that, and then we also need a phone. So let's just search for phone. And this would be perfect for what we're doing. Now let's go over to our font. And you can see that sometimes the names aren't 100% correct. So you can go in and redo it. So you can either call it envelope, mail, whatever you want. Now, there is an option for quick usage, which you can click this, and they'll give you actually the CSS you can put in there. That way you don't have to download anything. It'll automatically change. But if you're using the free account, you're going to have to download it because after 24 hours, this will get deleted and it won't be accessible. So I'm going to show you exactly how to download it. But if you wanted to use this, you could for quick access. So let's download this. And I downloaded it. And I'm going to upload this. Now, it does come with a demo, so you can make sure it's the right one. And I'd like to actually upload this demo to HTML as well to my files because it really makes things easier if I need to remember what this what the icon is actually called, so if I need to go use it, or to check what icons I actually have in this library. So let's go over here, and we're going to go check where we want this. Since an icon is really, in the end of the day, it's a CSS, we're going to make another thing, another folder within CSS called icons. And we're going to drag all of this. So we're going to drag all of this within my icons folder. And great. Now we can actually test to make sure we have this in the correct spot by going to slash CSS slash icons. And we want to go to our demo.html folder. You can see our demo page does come up. So that's great. Now, we want to make sure we load it into our resources. Now, obviously, it's not going to be there yet because we haven't done any code, but we want to make sure that our style sheet for our icons will show up there. So let's go in over here to our some code. And since the it doesn't really matter where you put the CSS, I usually like to put it above everything else since sometimes you might need to override it. Something that doesn't really change anyway. But we're going to create a style sheet link. So and we're going to have to source it to here. So to source it, we want to go into our CSS folder first, and then into icons, which is right here, and then call the CSS. So style.css. And let's access that, and then this makes sure that it actually loaded. So you refresh the page. You can see that it definitely is loading, which is perfect. And now what we want to do is we want to call, we can go back to our font, and we want to call this. Now, the kind of way that IsoMoon sets this up is that it uses icon dash and then mail for each one as a class name. So the way we're going to write this is I like to do an I tag for short for icon. I'm going to call it class. And all you do is do icon slash whatever your name is. Now we haven't styled this, so but we do get access to it. Now for our other icon, you can probably guess what this is going to be called. And it's going to be a class icon, and we called it phone. Let me just make sure that it works. Now, we now want to style this, and because these icons are done as a font, that's how we get the vector. You style these differently than how you would style an image, because you're actually adjusting the font color. So because these tags are eyes, we can actually customize that. We have to call the actual eye, and we want to call it within maybe the hat. So let's go over to our CSS and do header.hat, and we'll go to eye, which is for the icon. And let's color this, and let's just do red just to make sure it works. You can see it did change. But from our PSD, we want to get it to be this exact blue. So let's go in here, get the exact blue that we're looking for. I like to use the eyedropper. And you can just use the eyedropper to get that. Get right in the middle. I'm going to select the hex code. And I'm going to do hex code like this. A hex code always starts with the little pound sign. Refresh, you can see that now they're definitely looking nice. Now, you can see that these are a little bit bigger, which are nice. You can actually go in here and usually tell what size they are. Sometimes they, in this case, I guess they use the a vector that they made themselves. So we can't really use that as an icon font. Sometimes they use Font Awesome or something in here. So we're going to have to just kind of guess and check a little bit. And what I like to do is I like to use Inspect Element and go in here. I'm going to customize this. So this seems a little bit weird at first because it is a font. You have to use font size. And let's try like 12 pixels. We can go a little bit bigger. So we can go up to 20 pixels. That looks like a nice little size for us. See how it maybe looks with 24. I think 20 is about the right size. Like, I'm using the arrows to change that. I'm going to just copy this into place. I'm going to save what I'm doing. Now the next thing would be that there needs to be a little bit of padding between the icon and the words. So we can go in here and we can actually add some padding, just like we added padding to the li. And we can kind of just customize this a little bit. I'm going to go with 15. And since we can also do the same thing with the other icon over here. But in this case, I think I'm actually just going to remove the Skype one, since I know for a fact this project isn't going to need Skype. That being said, we now have an icon font, and you're able to customize your icons and play around with them. If you have any questions about this, please let me know, and I will talk to you later.